Silva Machado from the state of Santa Catarina. The ball's delivered into the box. The deflection. Very, very dangerous. That one almost found the back of the net. The deflection on the first post from that guy right there, Nacho Fernandes. Take a look at it once again. Almost finding the back of the net. The first. Here's Junior Alonso. He's going to chip this ball to Jair. Not the best of controls. Eric Ramirez wins it. Links up with Artur. The low cross into the box. And it's booted out of trouble by Nathan Silva. Here's Leo Ortiz. Links up with Artur. He's going to swing this into the box with his left foot. The deflection. And we have the opener. Goal! For Red Bull Bragantino. It's Italo, as usual, in the right place at the right time, deflecting this one into the back of the net to beat Everson and to put 1-0 on the scoreboard. Will you take a look at it again? Leo Ortiz, Artur, swings this ball into the box, the deflection from Italo, and there it is. Red Bull Bragantino break the deadlock, draw first blood, and put 1-0 on the scoreboard at the Nabi Abi Shadid. It's Italo who once again on the score sheets. Mauricio Destri.
Absolutely nothing Everson could have done. And check out these milestones today. It's game number 150 for Italo.
Ideal position to curve this ball into the box. Here it comes. Looking for Nathan Silva, the header there. Met by another header from Hena. It's a loose ball into the box. Oh, it's saved by Clayton. Spectacular once again on the sideline by Leo Ortiz. And what's it going to be? From the looks of it, it's a penalty kick.
What?
For Atletico Mineiro, Leo Ortiz saved that ball on the line with his arm. That's what the referee, Braulio da Silva Machado, is signaling. Of course, we're going to get a replay here. We're going to take a look at it once again. Mauricio Barbieri, as expected, is protesting, having a word with the fourth referee. The officials say, back off, my friend.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at it again. The header here from Nathan Silva, a subsequent header by Hena. It's picked up by Guga, the first time shot. And my question is, if Guilherme Arana is offside there. No doubt about it, his shot was saved on the line by Leo Ortiz's hand. So will the VAR step into action? There it is.
Is it hand?
Or rather his arm. It might be unintentional, though. I assume the VAR.
Yeah, Anthony, I can't remember the last time we saw a PK plus a red card being awarded here in Brazil, but that is exactly what Mauricio Barbieri was complaining about. He was saying you can punish him two times or punish the team twice. So, yeah, pretty sure that was an onside position, or was it? I'm sure the VAR is checking that exactly, because that would cancel the whole play. So, I'm still unclear to see whether or not he touches his chest first or straight to his arm. I don't know. But anyway, interesting situation here. Possible penalty, a red card. Exciting 20 minutes.
Rodrigo Nunes de Sá, a referee from the state of Rio, is taking a look at that play. Certainly a tricky one to analyze. And, of course, the referee being pressured by a few Atlético Mineiro players. And he's going to have a look at the play himself over on the VAR monitor on the sidelines. And he's telling the Roosters to back off. You see Nathan Silva as well as Keno.
Yeah, if he's going to take a look, probably the VAR team is in doubt whether or not it actually touched his hand or not, or chest. Because in an offside position, pretty clear.
All eyes right now on the referee, Braulio da Silva Machado, and he's looking at this particular frame, and from the looks of it, Guilherme Arana is indeed a tad bit offside when we have the touch right there from the right back, Guga. It took a deflection on the way, it appears, from Hurtado.
There's the control from Guilherme Arana.
All right.
He turns, took the shot. At first, it was saved by Clayton. The rebound was saved by Leo Ortiz's hand.
So no offside in the play. Has deflected on Hurtado, right?
Here it is. The shot from Guilherme Arana, saved by Clayton. The rebound picked up by the same Arana. He fires. And it's saved by Leo Ortiz's right arm. It's unintentional, but nonetheless saved by his arm. So the referee, Braulio da Silva Machado, is reviewing this play over on the VAR monitor that's typically located on the sidelines. And you can hear all the shouting that's going on in the stands. The fans pressuring the ref, who's made up his mind. What's it going to be?
Wow.
Offside.
What a complex
situation. And the red card is canceled. And I genuinely do agree with the decision from the ref and the VAR team. This is why we have the VAR tool. The offside is given. Lucky for Leo Ortiz, his red card is called off. And he's going to live to fight another day. So the penalty kick is canceled as well.
Obviously us, the players, the game itself. Very good VAR in action tonight.
Jadson. Elinho cuts inside, fires with his left foot, a very decent strike. Inches wide of that right post. Another effort from the Regional Bragantino 11. This time closer to the target. Take a look at it once again. Elinho now. Arthur, the first time touch to Eric Ramirez. Hurtado now cuts inside. The cross met by Nathan Silva. The clearance picked up by Eric Ramirez. He's inside the box. Another cross, the touch, and it's almost Regional Bragantino's second. The effort inches wide of that right post, and it was Sorriso, the winger, with a touch. Here's the replay. Great work from Eric Ramirez. The low cross. And Sorriso, so unlucky. He couldn't find the back of the net.
That disallowed that goal, or the penalty kick, excuse me. Set goal because, come on, PK plus a red card.
There's Scano. Nacho curves this ball into the box. It's steered away by Leo Ortiz. The first time hit. Very good, forcing Clayton to work. What a strike. And what a save from that guy right there. If I'm not mistaken, I had the shot earlier. We're going to take a look at it again. Here it is. The clearance from Leo Ortiz. And the first time hit from Alan. Forcing Clayton to come up with a great save. The service into the box. Dangerous. Steered away. It's picked up by Guga. The shot. And it's almost the equalizer. That ball just inches away from Clayton's right post. Here's the replay. It almost found the back of the net. It took a deflection.
Abertura pelo lado esquerdo. Olha o Keno. Partiu em velocidade. Toque por baixo. Chega na cobertura. Ortiz. A bola ainda volta. O chute de longe. Pega o Clayton. Defesaça do goleiro do Red Bull Bragantino. Chega de novo o Atlético com muito perigo, Piperno.
O Clayton
passa, o Atlético agora vai bem, hein? Bola do Nacho pro Arana. O Nacho já passa. Prefere o toque no meio pro Jair. Olha a finta do Jair. Arana domina. Toca a bola pro Guga. Vai arriscar o Guga pra fora. A bola subiu demais, tinha jogador do lado direito livre, Piperno.
O Keno passando livre, mas outra vez o Atlético consegue finalizar da entrada da área. Já foram várias vezes com o Alan, essa é a segunda do Guga, também o Jair. O Atlético tem.
Apresenta. Aí, ó, é falta, hein? Um, dois, três, quatro homens na barreira, não tem ninguém deitado. Olha o chute do Nacho! Golaço! Gol! Do Atlético! Nacho Fernandes, Honra a camisa número 26, na cobrança de falta ensaiada, ele bateu com uma categoria danada. O Cleiton só ficou observando a bola entrar. Nátio Fernandes empata o jogo em Bragança. Um para o Red Bull Bragantino, um para o Atlético Mineiro, Fábio Piperno.
Ah, destacava o Nátio agora há pouco, né? Sou fã dele, como joga a bola esse argentino, um cara refinado, de toque bonito na bola. Tá difícil, porque para contra-golpear tem que trabalhar a bola, tem que ter um jogador que consiga acionar os homens de frente.
Olha o toque, o chute, sai, volta para a equipe do Atlético. Vai entrar o Sávio, hein? Olha o Arana, cruzamento para a área, toque de cabeça para fora! Perde a chance o Atlético Eduardo Sacha. Recebeu na área, olha de novo, ó, o Arana cruzou, o Sacha cabeceou, tava numa condição tranquila para cabecear, ele já tinha ganho do Renan, mas a bola foi para...